Youngie's story that we get to finally see explored in episode 4 is one of pure joy and celebration and happiness, but also one of complete and utter devastating loss. When I got the script in for 4, I was reading it, I was actually in tears. Of course, young Ian he's a part of me, you know what I mean? I feel for him so deeply, so when I'm reading this, it almost feels like it's happening to me too.
Those scenes with young Ian where he reflects on his life with the Mohawk, I think are very touching. It's such a strong, vivid tone, and you know, Outlander always surprises. I think here in this episode, we get to see Jamie and Ian really bond. Young Ian has been through some sort of traumatic experiences. He came back from the Mohawk and there's something different about him, and it's really affected him and changed him as a human being. And he reveals that to Jamie, and I think Jamie is extremely touched by that.
My daughter, Faith, she was also lost. I never held her either.
When he finally is able to find the strength to open up to Jamie and tell his story, you understand, finally, why he was in such a bad state of mind.
Come. We shall ask my daughter to look for yours in heaven.
We get given these gifts of scenes that are, you know, quite emotional and tender. And obviously working with John Bell as Ian, he's fantastic. When you walk on set, you're sort of thrown into this Cherokee village, and it's just, as an actor, you don't have to recreate anything in your head. It's all there in front of you. It's almost like time travel.
In last season, it was revealed to young Ian that he's in the family of time travelers, and they have the knowledge of what's going to happen, and he is burdened with this knowledge, with the fact that he knows that America doesn't treat Native Americans very well. They drive them off their ancestral lands, kill many of them, and he has this knowledge and he doesn't know what to do with it. He's going to find out the pressures that Jamie's under on a daily basis with this knowledge, that Claire's under, you know, with the Mackenzies as well.
As obviously we know, the whole show is rooted through time travel. There's this through line of real historical events.
We'll call it the Trail of Tears.
We sort of see history through their eyes as future people, as viewers. We see it through these future characters and see it all unfolding and happening before them.
It didn't seem right to know and not tell you.
We watch the sort of helplessness. They have such a good historical knowledge and they can't do anything about it.
I hit it.
You've been practicing.
It's a very difficult situation that they're in because they know ultimately how the war will play out. So they're trying to play the best hand that they can at the time they have it. It's very difficult because at the moment they really need to side with the crown. They know that being an Indian agent and possibly arming the Indians in one sense is great because they should be able to defend themselves. But is it potentially arming somebody that will then end up being on the other side of the battle line to themselves? And it's a very difficult line that Jamie's gonna have to play, and it really weighs on him.
Some 60 years from now, your people will be taken from their land.
We knew when young Ian came back from the Mohawk that we were going to do his story in this season. And we wanted to play it out completely. We wanted to kind of devote an episode to it. To bring back Braden, who played Kahilaton.
Kahilaton, who we first met back in season 4, is almost like a brother to him. They really do understand each other and trust each other immensely. In fact, he is there at the beginning, supporting Young Ian's love for Wah Yong Hawe. It breaks my heart because he really does try to fight for her. You can see that she does still love him, but without being able to have a child, imagine that every time you look at someone, all you see is loss. And I think that's what they both finally come to understand. Then when she finds someone else and it's Kahilaton, that's like an extra stab to the heart for Ian. Here's somebody that he thought of as a brother who has now come in and, as he sees it, stolen his love from him. Thankfully, they do have that moment to reconcile.
If I die, go to her.
There's that beautiful moment I love, and I think this whole season is him finding his way back to his family, to the people that really will care about him forever. And of course, you can't mention family in Young Ian without his loyal sidekick, Rollo. I think that's truly his shadow and his most loyal companion.